Thank you. So, why Springfield?
I get asked that a lot, and I choose to live here because Springfield is a place that I can enjoy the life I want.
I love the outdoors.
You can be on the lake in just a short drive.
It only takes me 10 minutes to get to work.
Or off to anywhere in the world.
I know my kids will be safe and well educated.
There are really good job opportunities after graduation.
I'm able to work remotely and create on a high level.
The healthcare options in this area are incredible.
The options for housing and cost of living are so affordable.
We have room to create.
I love to experience the excitement of sports.
Can't beat the food.
Or the drinks.
Why Springfield? Because all the pieces you need to create your own story are here. The only thing missing is you.
Become the person you're really meant to be. How do you reach beyond what you thought was possible? The answer isn't about the destination. It's in the journey. It starts when you become part of something bigger, when you join a community that works together to lift each other up, a place where you form lifelong relationships and encounter life-changing experiences. It all starts when you go beyond. At Drury University, we take a personalized approach in combining hands-on learning, meaningful mentorship, and real-world results to make sure you have every opportunity to succeed in both your life and career. Maybe it's fusing your passion for research with your devotion to caring for others, or turning your love of learning into a lifetime of teaching. Maybe it's realizing a busy life doesn't mean you have to give up on your lifelong dreams. Or using music to do something more than just entertain. Or combining your entrepreneurial spirit with your affection for the arts. The path you take is up to you, but you won't be alone. Along the way, you'll receive mentorship from faculty who take the time to understand you, whether it's staying after class to look over an assignment or just hanging out during office hours. Your journey starts here, but the Drury experience goes beyond the boundaries of the classroom and around the world. So get outside your comfort zone, join a club, play a sport, get loud, take center stage, ask to have class outside just because you can. Fuse your brightest ideas with your best memories. And if you get knocked down, get back up. We'll be here for you. This is your journey. This is where you belong. Look around. This is where you become who you're meant to be.
Today will not be easy, but you did not choose the easy path. Easy is not who we are. We are
Drury!
You will be tested every minute that you are out there, and you will be better for it. We are
Drury! There's no time for fear in this room. When I look in your eyes, I see focus. I see intensity. I see an unrelenting desire to be unstoppable.
You have been waiting for this moment, and your moment is here.
Who are we?
We are Drury!
Who are we?
We are Drury!
Who are we?
We are!
Live from Jordan Valley Ice Park, Stan Milton Ice Arena. It is game two between the Drury University Panthers and the University of Arkansas. Hello, everybody. Steve Cassin along with Amari Johnson and Scott Letzky. Oh, my gosh. He's live in the house.
In the house. That's right.
Yeah, let's get you set up, man. You're hot.
Yep. My wife may disagree with that, but whatever.
There you go. And I didn't mean it any other way than a hot microphone. But
so it's probably a good thing that I'm here because it doesn't sound like you're doing so hot.
I am not. I am glad that I kind of had yesterday off because as we count down to the reason for my sickness or any kind of sickness that I've had. But, you know, it's just the average things that are going on here across the atmosphere, I guess, whatever you want to call it. Bottom line is I'm here, but I've been nursing a voice for the last few days. But let's take a look at the Cadence Insurance pregame report here as these two teams meet. The Drury Panthers, they are 15-6-2 this season, and they will be attending their first postseason tournament in program history after finishing number 13 and securing a Division II Central Region bid. Drury will play the number 8 Sioux College in the first round, February 23rd and 25th at Patterson Ice Arena in Grand Rapids. And if you take a look at yesterday's game, including yesterday's game, the Panthers are 6-3-2 over the past 10 games, including a 7-1 win over Arkansas last night. And this is how it kind of happened here with Ferguson getting his 15th, O'Rourke his 18th, Fournier his 4th, and Kane his 4th in the first period. Ferguson gets one in the second. O'Reilly also a power play goal, and that chased the starting goaltender in net for the Razorbacks, and that starting goaltender was Sam Haynes. Then in the third period, the Panthers get a power play goal to make it 7-0, but they also do surrender the shutout as a goal by David Markovich makes it a 7-1 final. Arkansas now 18-10, and Drury, they're going to finish the regular season. In fact, actually, Drury has won 4 in a row, including a sweep over the number 11 Maryville and on February 2nd and 3rd, and then a split with the number 1 Lindenwood the weekend of January 27th and 28th. And as I mentioned, they will finish the regular season with 3 of the 4 games at home, including tonight with Arkansas, and 2 against Oklahoma State on March 1st and 2nd. Let's take a look at some of the leaders for the Drury Panthers, and that includes Jacob Hawley, who is the leading scorer, 12 goals and 32 assists, 43 points for him. He has 3 goals in 6 games, does Jacob Hawley. He leads the team in assists and points, had 3 assists last night, has a 2-game goal scoring streak also with the goal and an assist yesterday. Second for the Drury Panthers, and that is Keegan Ferguson, who is now in second with a 3-game point scoring streak, second on the team in goals. He has 3 5-point games this season. He has an 8-game point scoring streak and a hat trick last night against the Arkansas Razorbacks, that is. It's the cold, Scott. It's affecting me. Let's take a look at the third leading scorer for the Drury Panthers. That's Ethan O'Rourke. Got a goal last night. He leads the team in goals. He has a 3-game goal scoring and a 5-game point scoring streak, and has 7 power play goals to lead the Drury Panthers with 36 points this season. Looking at the fourth leading scorer, and it's a defenseman. Francis Young-Menard got an assist last night, has a 2-game assist streak, second in team assists. He's again the top scoring defenseman in team history with 25 points, averaging just over a point per game. Looking at the fifth leading scorer for the Panthers, that's Louis Fournier. Got a goal last night, 2-game goal scoring streak, and has 3 assists. That was back against Iowa on December 9th. Tonight, though, Louis Fournier is out of the lineup. We'll take a look at the scratches here in just a bit. But as we continue on with the Drury Panthers, and we look at the goaltenders, as you see, Joshua Robbins in 10 games, he's 7-1-2. Grayson Skirpan in 7, he is 4-3. And Brett Sweet in 6 games, 4-2. Brett Sweet won his last start against Maryville on February 2nd, stopped 37 of 38 shots, and Sweet will be in net tonight for the Drury Panthers. As we look at our breakaway player, Web Sports Radio breakaway player, that of course, Sam Stack. And an assist last night. He's the only senior on the team that'll be graduating, and the first player in team history to be a graduate for the Drury Panthers. Hold on to that. That's a trivia question. I'll be asking that next year. Let's take a look at the visitors and the Arkansas Razorbacks. They are 18-10 after that 7-1 loss to Drury last night. Arkansas down 4-0 after one period, 6-0 after 40 minutes of play. So the leading scorers did not get any points last night. That includes Trevor Borlas, Kyle Cruz, Connor Chapman, and Brendan Kuhn, along with DJ Duenwald. Borlas is the leader with 33 points, Cruz with 26, Chapman with 25, and fourth is Kuhn. In fact, Kuhn yesterday racked up some penalty minutes too. He was involved in a scrum that took place in the third period, late in the third. He was given a game misconduct, a 10-minute misconduct, and had an additional penalty for roughing. So he picked up some penalties yesterday. J.D. Duenwald is fifth, averaging 0.81 points per game as we look at the top five leaders for the Arkansas Razorbacks. Taking a look at goaltending. They do have four goaltenders listed. Only three have seen action. And Sam Haynes, 10-5. He had the loss yesterday, played just two periods. Grady Reese comes in. He's now 7-4. Did not get a decision in yesterday's game. 3.14 goals against average, an .888 save percentage with a shutout. He will be in net tonight for the Arkansas Razorbacks. Noah Goodwin, also 1-1 this season. 3.0 goals against average for him. And you look at the combined down below for the Arkansas Razorbacks. A big difference for the Razorbacks this season compared to last season. But as you look at the matchups here, yeah, we count down to the matchup. Panthers and Razorbacks. Panthers 15-6-2 on the season. The record, though, to the Razorbacks, percentage-wise, 18-10. They have scored more goals than the Panthers, but the Panthers have given up the least amount of goals, a goal differential of 40. On the power play, as you take a look at the special teams and the Panthers lead in that, 32.4%, 33 of 102. And for the Arkansas Razorbacks, 25%, 26 of 104. Penalty kill, 81.1% for the Panthers, 17 of 90 they have allowed, and 27 of 120 for 77.5 for the Razorbacks. The Panthers have made their way out. Well, actually, the Razorbacks have. Here come the Panthers. As we round out the Cadence Insurance pregame report, we'll be heading down to Kevin Klein, the public address announcer, in just a second as we get ready to start this game. Take a look at the scratches while we have a second here. As I mentioned, several scratches for the Panthers. Joseph Pachuta's out, Tyler Sinlenpaw, Jake Lyons, Brody Behan, Matthew Tisdale, Patrick Labutis, Ben Parker, Zahn Werner, Cordy Fournier, or Louis Fournier, and Cody Larenko. Out for Arkansas, Cade Vinnick, Michael Gadishvili, Nolan Hall, Braden Asher, and Zach Kilgore also out of the lineup. It's loud, and that means we need to head on down to the public address announcer, Kevin Klein, for the introduction of the on-ice festivities.
Mark Marzola and David Hill, linesman Garrett Limpert. Penalty box officials, Pat Kane and Jaden Robb. Steve Kasson, Scott Lutzky, and Amari Johnson with Web Sports Radio are your broadcast team. And our music director is the Don of the Diddy, Mick Ashlock. Now, ladies and gentlemen, before we meet tonight's starting lineups, this is senior night for the Panthers. And we'd like to honor and recognize number 21, defenseman Sam Stack. A native of Springfield, Sam graduated from Kickapoo High School. While at Kickapoo, he was a member of the National Honor Society, the Kickapoo Golf Team, and the 2019 state champion Springfield Spirit High School hockey team. At Drury, Sam has excelled in the classroom, making the Dean's List in 2022 as an architect major with a business administration minor. On the Panthers golf team from 2020 to 2022, Sam was the 22 Panther Pride Award recipient, an award given to an individual that exemplified any one of these characteristics or a combination of them, an outstanding academic record, a positive role model, an unsung hero, and the embodiment of the team player. Sam joined Panthers hockey in its inaugural season of 2022-2023, and tonight, he is joined by his proud parents, Mom Stacy and Dad Chris, along with his sister, Sydney. Panthers fans, please join us in appreciation for the Stack family and your lone Panther senior, number 21, Sam Stack!
Okay, Kevin Klein is very happy about that.
And now, for the starting lineups for tonight's game. First, for the visiting Arkansas Razorbacks, at left wing, number 21, J.D. Dunwald. At right wing, number 14, Brendan Kuhn. At center, number 44, David Markovich. Left defense, number 29, Chris Yontz. Right defense, number 39, Ethan Rogers. In goal, number 31, Grady Reese. The Razorbacks head coach is Keller Sims, assistant coach, Ryan Urban. And now, Panthers fans, on your feet and get loud as we meet the starters for your Drury University Panthers. At left wing, a sophomore from Plattsburgh, Missouri, number 23, Gannon Stegall. At right wing, a sophomore from Richmond, Virginia, number 25, Luke Kangas. At center, a junior from Springfield, Missouri, number 80, Tyler Kane. At left defense, a senior from Springfield, Missouri, number 21, Sam Stack. At right defense, a sophomore from San Jose, California, number 3, Devin Gilligan. And in goal, from Calgary, Alberta, Canada, number 35, Brett Sweet. The Panthers are joined tonight by 8-year-old Jake Reed, a student at Schofield Elementary School in Republic and a participant in Jordan Valley Ice Park's Springfield Ice Cubs. The Panthers are led by head coach Jeremy Law, assistant coaches birthday week boy Cliff Cook and Brett Lathan. The Panthers athletic trainer is Sarah Robinson and strength coach is Corey Roy. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you continue standing if you're able, and gentlemen, remove your caps as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
National anthem from Jordan Valley Ice Park, Stan Melton Ice Arena, as we get ready for game number 2 between the Drury University Panthers, ranked number 13 in the Central of Division 2, and the University of Arkansas Razorbacks, ranked number 10 in Division 3. I'm Steve Kasson, along with Amari Johnson, Scott Letzke. He is live here in the house tonight. Scott, first time in what? Several weeks.
Yeah, it's at least a month.
Over a month, yeah.
Yeah, I think so. It's just so damn convenient doing this from my office at home.
Well, absolutely. It looks convenient. It looks nice and cozy.
But, you know, when I heard that Sam was going to be graduating and this was his senior night, having coached him and been a manager of teams that he's been on before, and I was there for his high school senior night.
Sure.
And so it was nice that I was able to come out and be here live for that.
Drury University skates from the left to the right and from the right to the left under the Arkansas Razorbacks. We are underway in period number one. And quickly, puck is sent in by David Markovich all the way into the Panthers zone. That'll be picked up by Devin Gilligan. As an assist here in this season, centering pass is intercepted, broken up, taken away by the Panthers. On a backhander, it's Gannon Stegall to flip it out to center. Across the Razorback line, drive sent wide by Tyler Keane. Into the corner now. Big hit there by Luke Kangas. It's the line of Gannon Stegall, Luke Kangas, and Tyler Keane. Shot the other way, saved there by Grady Reese. Panthers will pick it up. They'll bring it across the line. Now to Keane. He'll have it. Looking for some help behind the net. Gets bowled into the back of the boards by Brian Romero. Kept in by the Panthers. They want to line change, and they'll do it now. Picked up from behind his own net by Chris Yontz for the Razorbacks. Sent to the corner now, protecting everything is J.D. Duenwald. 12 goals, 10 assists for Duenwald. Had a shootout game winner this season. So that is not counted on the stats of the 131 goals that the Arkansas Razorbacks have scored this season. Puck is deflected up and out of play, so we'll have a faceoff. It should stay in the Arkansas zone, in the Panthers zone. Scott, you may have to take over. I'll tell you what.
I can tell you right now, the people that are listening and watching at home do not want that to happen.
You know, you've got the puck, they've got the puck, all that kind of stuff. Now it's the Panthers. It'll get better. It's just been one of those weeks for me. I tried everything to get better. Good thing there was only one game. Puck off the boards, taken by Ethan O'Rourke. A drive in and a good deflection on the stick check by Truman Hershey. Puck taken away, and it's cleared out to center ice. Panthers in their own zone. Still not able to grab. One shot officially, and that goes to the Arkansas Razorbacks. Lead pass coming in front is Ferguson. He shoots, and a save by Reese. Ferguson with a potential break there and a possibility of a goal. Now a drive in again, and it's saved by Reese on the attempt by Ferguson. Keegan Ferguson, 17 goals, 20 assists. He's second in scoring with 37 points. But if you look at the Panthers, their top three scorers are the three on the same line: Jacob Hawley, Keegan Ferguson, and Ethan O'Rourke. When you talk about spreading the wealth out right now, those are the players that are doing it all statistically for the Panthers. And here they come across the line. Drive comes in. Reese makes the save on O'Connor. And the puck is out to center ice, taken by Quinn O'Reilly. One goal, one assist for him. He will be our intermission guest in the second period. And you'll hear me allude to the fact that every time I interview a player, they get a goal. Well, he had one in yesterday's game. This interview took place on Thursday of this week. Here's a drive in right down the middle by Ethan Motor, and a good save by Brett Sweet. He'll hold on. So the streak is still alive, if you want to call it that. Every time I talk to a player, they get a point or something. And we've been having some issues with our video. That's our next project, get the video straightened out. Buck dropped down with 16:46 to go in the period and no score. Shots 3-2. They've updated them in favor of Drury. Up from the high slot, Rogers with a drive. It gets deflected away. And the Panthers have possession. They're slowly getting it through. And then all of a sudden, through all of this, Kyle Patterson gets slammed down. The Panthers really weren't moving anything. And then Patterson tried to split between two of them, and he gets shoved into the boards. Now here is Gifford with a drive. It is blocked, so the follow-up missing by Chris Yontz. 19 points for him. Two of those are goals. We're going to get an icing call here. 16:08 to go in the period. Faceoff will come back down into the Panthers end of the ice. Panthers are not finished yet. They have games next, well, in 2 weeks, actually. That'll be the 1st and 2nd of March. That will be against the team that they started the season with and Oklahoma State. Panthers, of course, already know who they're going to play in regionals. Arkansas, they finished number 10, I believe, as rankings, I think, have finished. Have to verify that. 15:56 to go in the period. Puck to the near sideboards. Back behind the net. And now Arkansas. They work the puck. Shots 3-3. The only goal scorer yesterday, David Markovich, with it. Gets it to the point. Sent right back down by Truman Hershey. Work behind the net to Markovich. Trying to work the puck. Markovich points in 5 of 6 games. Had a goal in yesterday's game and a 5-game goal scoring streak. Actually, a 5-game point streak is what he has. Panthers still can't clear. Sam Stack could not direct it into the way he wanted. Comes right out in front, tipped wide. On the doorstep was Hershey, and he just tipped it wide. Arkansas with a line change. Drury will try to do the same. 14:55 and the clock rolling here. Panthers out of their own zone. They're working in front of their own bench. Across the line now comes Hunter Finley. Finley through, and he tried to dipsy-doodle through, and he just lost it before trying to get a shot off. He was low along the goal line, and he ran out of trajectory there. Now Kane with it for the Panthers. Kane works through a check of Cruz. Comes right up the middle, and Reese makes the save. Good save there on Schmitz. Now Schmitz will shovel it down. Cruz will intercept. And he'll bring it with a 3-on-3 into the zone over to the left side to Trevor Borlas. Borlas' pass. Back down to Cruz. Tipped in front to Borlas. Borlas behind the net. Tries to work it with 14:07 to go in the period and no score. Shots 5-4 in favor of Arkansas now. Puck taken away and cleared and sent back out into the Arkansas zone. Not cleared from the zone yet. And Stegall kind of gave up the chase. Had he been a little bit more persistent, he might have been able to pick that puck up. But it stays in the zone anyway. Stegall with it. Stegall looking to the left side. Kept in by Finley. Back to Stegall. Up to Finley. He waits. Stegall left side. Shoots in. Save Reese. Rebound. Taken to the corner and cleared. Arkansas with it. Here's Borlas. Line change for the Razorbacks. Panthers do get the puck in. And they will send it in with a line change. No icing there. In their own zone. Chris Jontz wearing number 29, usually a goaltender's number. No rule says it has to be one, but that's what his number is. Puck to the back of the net in the Panthers zone. Worked off the boards. Panthers can't clear. Almost worked in by Rogers. Now the Panthers have it. They bring it onside into Hawley. His pass broken up, taken away by the Razorbacks, and Verbal will send it in. Panthers have it. They have a 2-on-1. Now a 2-on-2 broken up on a nice play. Good play there by Ethan Rogers. Line change for the Panthers. Line change for Arkansas. Puck comes in the Arkansas zone, kept in, and we're going to get a whistle. Penalty is coming up. It's a slashing call. And it goes against Drury, arguing is Ethan O'Rourke, and it's going to be a penalty against O'Rourke. And he's not happy about that one. Slash will be the call. Razorbacks get their first chance at the power play. They are 25%. Penalty kill, the Panthers are 81.1%. They've only allowed 17 on 90 opportunities.
O'Rourke, two-minute minor for slashing. Time of the penalty, 7:41.
Now here's Rogers. Over to Cruz. Across the line, left side, Connor Chapman. Chapman stops up. 12 goals, 13 assists for Chapman. Mentioned that the top players, and Chapman is number three, the top players, top five at least, did not have any points yesterday. The only two players with points was, of course, the goal scorer and David Markovich. As some pressure here put on the Panthers. 1:10 to go in this power play. Panthers are okay with just letting time run away. Puck into the right corner. It's taken away and cleared. Rogers with it. We'll get our video feed for you back here in just a second. 29 seconds remaining in the power play. Shots are 5-5, no score, 10:45 to go in the period. Right side, intending to get a shot off, was Romero. And he fanned on it. Romero's the only other point getter. He had an assist in yesterday's game. Puck ups to Romero, 8 seconds to go. Over to the left side, trying to work the puck around. Spinning it all the way is Duenwald. Power play is expired. We're back to 5-on-5. Romero drops it down in low. A backhander comes in. It's deflected. Panthers cannot clear the zone, and a shot just missed wide. Markovich missed on the left side. Now out in front. Panthers still can't clear. A blast in missed by Romero, and finally it's cleared out to center ice. A couple of broken sticks on the ice as now more fall down. Do the sticks, players exchange, and we get finally the Panthers, not clearing it yet. They're all out of the zone except for Duenwald. He has possession, he shoots, and it gets deflected away. We're gonna get a penalty, and I believe it is going to go against Arkansas. It's an interference call. Interference will be the call against Duenwald. Panthers go on the power play.
J.D. Dunwald, 2 minutes for cross-checking. Time of the penalty, 10:27.
So cross-checking is the penalty. Although I don't think it was a cross-check. Here's O'Rourke with a drive, save, rebound! It's on the doorstep! O'Rourke had it, it hit the post, got past Grady Reese. It was on the doorstep, and Quinn O'Reilly could not poke it home. Panthers are that close to getting the first goal of the game. No score here with 9 minutes to go in the period. Up top. It goes over to Young Menard. Now to the left side, drive, and it got deflected as Ferguson got the shot off. 1:21 on the power play. Up high to Young Menard. Now to Hawley. To O'Rourke with a drive, and it just missed. Taken away and cleared out to center ice. Panthers quickly get it in. Arkansas caught in a line change. Out in front. Hawley, he shoots safe. Rebound! And it just missed wide. Panthers again with some great pressure. O'Rourke into the corner. Works it now to Ferguson with 57 seconds to go on the power play. Reese saw this Young Menard shot sail wide. Puck out to center as it goes to Verbal. He'll have it on the left side for Arkansas. Chipped away from him and sent down with 45 seconds remaining in the power play. 8:13 to go in the period. No score here. The Panthers have been close. Big difference from yesterday's game as the Panthers had a 4-0 lead in the first period. Puck is cleared with 27 seconds left in the power play. Panthers coming in 33 for 102, 32.4%. Now they have 14. It's an offside. Potentially a Stegel is there, so Panthers will set it up again with 7. Now they work it. Right side, into the zone. Kangas now. This one is Luke Kangas. He sends it over to the far side. Power play is over. We're back to 5-on-5. Held in by Stegel. Drop down in low. Intercepted now by Chris Yontz. Into the corner. Yontz will clear it out to center ice. Yontz with a power play goal this season, averaging just over 0.75 points per game in 26 games. 7:05 to go in the period. Duenwald gets upended, and we come the other way for the Panthers. They'll send it in, and it goes behind the net for Arkansas. Full line change for Drury. Now here comes Yontz. Yontz along with Hershey, the only two players that did not change for Arkansas. Drive behind the net. It hits the referee on its way in. 6:38 to go in the period, and no score. Panthers lead in shots 8-7, but they had some great opportunities on the power play as we get an icing call here. 550 feet from icing will bring it back into the Drury zone. Face off in the Panthers zone, one behind the net, taken by Arkansas, flipped past Tyler Borlas to the point, getting his stick pulled out of his hands is Hayden Doggett. He gets it back. We come around the net in the Panthers zone. Brendan Kuhn is there. A shot comes in, it's blocked by one of the Panthers in front, I believe that was Kangas. Puck is taken away, and it's cleared out to center ice. Gage Robb with it now, and Robb avoids a check, sends the puck in. Now Romero. He'll have it for Arkansas. Across the blue line, into the Panthers zone. Drury still leads in shots, but no score here in this period. Panthers have it. Lead pass comes across, in for O'Rourke with a blast in, and it missed. Wide to the right, comes out to center. Here's Markovic with it, waiting for someone to catch up. Gets a shot in, and it just missed wide. Right in front, trying to make some waves, was Freeman. Now the Panthers, behind their own net, 5:04 to go in the period. Behind the net, or excuse me, it is cleared in front as it was about to get sent back in. Now in front of the Panthers zone, sent right down. 4:40 to go in this period. Puck taken past Yontz and cleared all the way down. Officials say no icing. 4:30 to go. Here come the Panthers, 3-on-3, into the zone. O'Rourke's pass, tried to get it over to Hawley. Good play by Sam Carricker to break it up. Behind the net to Yontz, who intercepts. Pushing him is Quinn O'Reilly. It's the line of O'Reilly and Riley O'Connor, along with Brady Kangas. I joked about that earlier. I said, if you put Quinn O'Reilly on with Riley O'Connor, I'll call them different names. We'll hear about that in the interview that we'll have with Quinn O'Reilly coming up in the second period intermission. Here's Rogers. 3 goals and 15 assists for Rogers this season. Has a couple of power play goals to his credit. Now bad pass behind the net by Sweet. Panthers still with possession. Good pressure by Arkansas here. 3:27 to go in the period. Board battle along the goal line. dugout. Arkansas still with possession. Behind the net. As the Panthers are able to clear. Good work there by Hayden Doggett. Puck taken away and cleared out. That may have been 24, Caleb Schmitz, not 14. He goes to the bench. Panthers with it, tipped in by Luke Kangas. Now Kangas for the half boards, gets it to Tyler Kane, works around Hershey of Arkansas. Now Hershey with a follow, over to the left side. Drive comes in, Reese with the save, rebound to Kane. Kane shoots up high and he missed. Out to the point. Chipped back in by Anson Kiley with a couple assists this season for him. Puck to the point, and it was held in by Stegel, but taken away by Arkansas. They bring it across the line. Left wing shot by Chapman goes wide. 2:09 to go in the period. Still no score. Shots even up at 8 apiece. We get an icing call here. Puck will come back into the Panthers' end of the ice. Still no score. Face off on the right of Sweet. His left, right as you look at it. Panthers do get it out. And it'll be the Razorbacks with Duenwald. Kuhn with it now. Drury, number 13 in the Central of Division 2. They will be going to Division 1 the next season. Arkansas, number 10 in Division 3. They will be moving up to Division 2 next season. Now shot in, save, rebound, score! Duenwald got the initial shot, but we're going to also get a penalty on this, too. And there's a couple of players surrounded. One of them is Kangas. We know that. Luke is in there for Arkansas. Looks like Brendan Kuhn. So we'll see what all transpires here. So the officials are talking things over here. There is 2 minutes on the board to Luke Kangas, but I don't believe they're going to count this as a goal. It's still not up on the board. Unfortunately, we don't have a replay of it. Oh, now they put it up on the board, so they are going to count it. But 2 minutes and a power play for the Razorbacks. We'll hear the call on all of
Arkansas
it.
Goal scored by number 14, Brendan Kuhn. Assisted on the play by number 44, David Markovich, and number 21, J.D. Dunwald. Time of the goal, 18:31. Kuhn from Markovich and Dunwald at 18:31. Also at 18:31, Drury penalty to number 25, Luke Kangas. 2 minutes for cross-checking. Kangas, 2 minutes for cross-checking at 18:31.
So Kuhn will get his 15th of the season.
We are in the final minute of the first period.
And a power play once again for the Razorbacks, as there's now 1:14 remaining in the penalty to Kangas. But Arkansas, with Kuhn's 15th, makes it a 1-0 game. And a big difference yesterday, because Arkansas did not take the lead yesterday. And now they have two goals by Kuhn, his second goal. That's his 16th of the season. It's 2-0. .1942 will be the time of the goal.
Isn't that a power play goal?
Well, it should have been a power play goal, yeah. There's five out there.
14, Brendan Kuhn, assisted on the play by number 22, Connor Chapman, and number 52, Kyle Cruz. Time of the goal, 19:43. Kuhn from Goodwin, from Chapman.
Well, while we hear that, we're going to have some more pushing and shoving here on the near side boards. As everyone comes together to find out if they're going to Andy's or not tonight, and then we finally reminded them that there is no Andy's if there's five goals scored. But everything seems to have straightened up. Kuhn at 18:31, his 15th, Markovich and Duenwald. It's a 1-0 game. And then on the power play at 19:42, it's Kuhn with the 16th, Chapman and Cruz with the assists, 2-0. Razorbacks are now 1-for-2 on the power play. Panthers are 0-for-1. Shots on goal. Brett Sweet faces 9. Grady Reese, they've just updated it. Hold on a second here. So they've updated it to 12. So Brett Sweet faces 12. Grady Reese faces 8. And it's 2-0 after one period of play. We'll take a break. Trying to get everything else straightened out around here. And when we come back, it'll be Sam Stack. We'll talk to him, the only senior graduating and the first senior in team history to be a graduate. We'll do that in just a moment. 2-0, the visitors, Arkansas, after one. We'll be back.
Pearson Kelly Office Products presents
Great Moments in Office Technology.
When Julie gets bored at work, she writes funny captions to pictures of animals she found online. Then she realized she could send all of her pictures in one gigantic message to her coworkers. At that moment, Julie created Junk Email. Now, employees can enjoy their days watching auto-tuned sneezing pandas. There are plenty of ways to waste your company's money. Your copier shouldn't be one of them. Pearson Kelly Office Products. Business made simple.
We are back at Jordan Valley Ice Park, Stan Melton Ice Arena, talking with the only senior on the team in Sam Stack. And Sam, it's been a while since you've played. You had a cup of coffee with the club, but you finally get a chance this weekend to get in some games.
I know, I'm very excited. I love the atmosphere. I love hanging out with the boys, just playing some hockey. So any chance I get on the ice, I love it.
Now, I know you're a senior, but you might have some extra time available. You still going to play?
No, I think this is going to be my last year. I've really enjoyed the process and the journey, but I think it's to move on to better things, and I'm going to cherish every moment that I got left.
So time to get a big boy's job.
Yeah, sadly. It's moved way too fast.
So what do you want to be when you grow up then?
So right now I'm getting a major in architecture, and I think what I'm going to do, just kind of off the start, is to get some experience somewhere else, different fields, just kind of get a feel for what I like to do, where I think I fit best. I think in the end, I want to end up in a firm, but we haven't quite narrowed it down to what we're going to do yet. But I'm excited because I really enjoy going out and doing things that I'm not used to, I'm not necessarily great at, and just getting experience.
Architecture, maybe project management.
Yep, something like that.
Okay, there you go. Any type of field that you might want to look into?
No, not specifically. I think one of the things that interests me was something around landscaping. I think I want to kind of shoot my shot around there. But right now, primarily, I'm just looking at the design and process in general, and just hoping to get something around in those lines.
So design concept, design landscaping, mm-hmm. Things like that.
Yeah.
Okay. That's definitely, there is landscaping out there that, so I'm a project manager in my day job, mm-hmm. and we fight constantly with landscaping architects and landscaping companies in that they put out what's on the drawings, but the drawings are not the best.
Yeah, we get... I love the running joke of architects versus engineers. We come up with the pretty stuff, but we don't make it work, really able to work, and the engineers just got to figure it out. So
absolutely, with all their underground and everything like that. So yeah, it's good to go. We can talk all day about this, but let's talk more about you. So as I mentioned, you've had about a cup of coffee with this hockey club right now, just seven games. Six as you head into this weekend. Mm-hmm. You'll be able to play some more. But what do you take out of your time here with the hockey club?
Honestly, it's just been surreal. When I came to Drury, I actually was on the golf team for the first 2 years, and kind of thought my playing days were over competitively until we had the chance to make this team happen. And this, from day one, I've enjoyed every second of it. And I think that coming together with a bunch of guys and just spending our weeks together practicing, hunting, getting ready for playoffs, it's a place like no other. Playing, no playing, I absolutely love it.
Coming from the golf club, it's similar. I mean, mm-hmm. in a sense that you're swinging a ball, so you're hitting a puck. It's kind of the same thing, but you don't have the hitting. You don't have the continuous play. So what made you decide to take the transition from golf into hockey?
So growing up, I always used to do the two, and I always said that they were very good at counteracting each other, where golf, I had to be kind of more composed, stay together, make sure I'm going through the motions the right way. And sometimes with hockey, I can let my emotions out. I can get out there and kind of just express that more likely. And then just kind of the team versus the solo aspect. I'm in golf, you still go for a team, but it's all about how you mentally can get through that round versus when I'm sitting on the bench and we're talking with 20 guys and playing the game together. So it's just different atmospheres. And I think that Once I started playing golf, I knew that I was missing something, and this was just an opportunity I could take.
Sam Stack is joining us of the Drury Panthers. He is the only senior on the team. Kind of bittersweet because you'll basically be the only guy leaving, and the rest of the team will be out there. I'm assuming you'll be following the team later on down the line.
Oh yeah, I've already kind of had talks with the coaches, and I said if you guys need someone to work the benches, work the penalty box, you let me know. I'll show up to the games. I'll make sure it can happen. So, no, I love the guys, and I'll try to keep in touch. I'll try to make sure if they need anything here and there, I'm there for them.
Just the second year of this team, so you kind of are a trivia question. Who's the first senior to graduate from the team?
Mm-hmm. Me and my parents were talking about that. It is kind of a weird thing to talk about. I mean, it's something that I'm going to remember for forever, and I think it's going to be such a fun thing to tell other people as well along the line. So I don't know.
You said you grew up with hockey. So has hockey been your favorite sport?
No, I think actually golf was my calling for a while. I was very committed to that. I'd play all the time. Me and my dad were big avid golfers. My dad actually played at MSU when he was in college. So we've been big golfers our entire lives. And I think that kind of throughout the years, as I slowly kind of joined and got into hockey, they were both neck and neck. But I think golf overall for me was my sport.
Do you remember the first time you were on the ice?
Oh, yeah. It was right here on the other rink, and I remember it was a learn to skate, and I was doing fine. I could go forward. I could kind of go backwards, but the second they made me try to do stops, I had a hard, frustrating time, and it made me want to focus in, and the second I learned how to do that, I wanted to do everything. You couldn't get me off the ice.
Sam Stack of the Drury Panthers joining us. Senior, the only senior on the team. What age were you when you started skating?
So I was a little bit later. I actually didn't start skating until I was around 9, 10 years old, and then really didn't start competitively until 11, about to turn 12. So it was one that I picked up later, but I have been playing it ever since.
Such a slowpoke.
I know. I'm talking to the guys on the team. They're like, I started skating when I was 3. And I was like, man, I probably couldn't even stand on 2 feet when I was 3. So.
But you were probably golfing before they started golfing.
Oh, yeah. I think there's a picture of me somewhere about 5 years old swinging one of those plastic clubs. So they taught me young.
There you go. Who is your favorite NHL team?
I'm a big St. Louis Blues fan.
Will they make the playoffs this year?
Ooh, it's looking rough. I think we historically do pretty good in the second half, and I think we have a team that can grind it out and get there. We're no cup contenders by any means, but I'm going to be rooting for them, and I think they can pull it off.
The weird thing about St. Louis is they're the only team that went from worst to first,
mm-hmm.
and they did it in such a short amount of time, and they did it with a team that is similar to what this team is. You know, they're grindy. They're not a team that anybody expected to go anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe twice? Lightning strikes twice? I don't know.
Yeah, we're hoping, especially with the whole coaching change. It's definitely going to be down the stretch, kind of see where they're at mentally, and hopefully they can kind of push through and get the little edge, because I know we're pretty far down the standings right now, so we got to make some moves.
Sam Stack is joining us of the Drury Panthers, the only senior graduating this year. Speaking of coaching change, new coach this year, what's it been like to be under the rule, so to speak, of Jeremy Law, head coach, and Cliff Cook, assistant coach?
They've been awesome. I think our first year we were definitely kind of going through the motions and getting things rolling, but we definitely had some inexperience in some areas, and when these two guys came on, I mean, they brought our program together. I mean, they kind of showed us the path. They told us from day one we're making regionals, and
which we have,
and we all knew coming in. I mean, it got a little closer than we wanted to, but we knew we had the team to do it. So,
and you were a team for a while there that just couldn't win at home.
Mm-mm. No, our home record right now is suffering. It's not looking too good, but we're gonna change that for sure. Next year, when we split in the teams, I think we're really going to try to focus on making sure that we get the crowds here and we get the energy up.
3 of the next 4 are at home, so that's a good thing. Mm-hmm. You have to like that. And a kind of a home-and-home one-day thing with Arkansas, that's going to be interesting. But this year, Drury looks like they can possibly handle these Arkansas Razorbacks.
Oh, I think we can handle them very well. We've done our homework, and we put the time in, and I don't think there are many teams right now that are going to be able to stop what we're doing.
Describe the atmosphere, the locker room, the way it is on the ice with this hockey club.
Over the past weeks, we've been awesome. We've been really getting the energy up at practice. We've made sure that when we're playing as a team. We're playing for each other. We're making a lot of unselfish moves, and I think the guys are understanding that it's not going to be something that we can do individually, and it's been an awesome atmosphere both on and off the ice.
Sam Stack, senior with the Drury Panthers, joining us. You mentioned the Blues are your favorite team. Who is your favorite player?
Ooh, that's a tough one. I like Kyrou. I got to say he's such a fast kid. He goes everywhere, does everything. I think there's some drama with him for a little bit, but I think he's helping bring our franchise through the upcoming years.
Do you think he was a little misunderstood when he said what he said? And, of course, for folks that don't understand, he was referring to when they asked him about Craig Berube leaving the team, and he said, well, he's not my coach anymore, to that effect. Do you think he was a little misunderstood based on what he said?
I think so. I think that as a player, you kind of you have to understand that it's a sucky thing to realize, but it's a business. And I think he understood that there was a change. He may like it, he may not, but he's – He's already on to the next step. He's focusing on his game. He's focusing on that. And I, from an athletic standpoint, I don't see how you can blame him for that.
And it must be similar to the fact that, okay, you're out here to play hockey, but you're also out here to get an education first. Mm-hmm. And the way the NHL is, yes, it's a business, but at the same time, it's entertainment. And and it's different and difficult to understand the differences and the nuances between, okay, you're there to play as well as you can, but you need to entertain the fans.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you gotta have some spark going. You got to make sure that the buzz is still around you guys. I know it's something that is definitely a weird environment for, like, I haven't really experienced, but I think that a lot of the guys, they handle it pretty well.
Sam Stack, senior with Drury, is our guest. One final question. Do you have any brothers or sisters?
I have a sister.
She follow you, or does she play hockey?
No, she does not. She graduated a couple years ago, and she's actually going to be moving here in a little bit, but she's been to all the games, and she's been really supportive. My whole family's been really supportive through this process, so they love the hockey atmosphere, and they love showing up.
Sam, at the end of interviews, I always wish players more goals. In this case, you have not scored a point yet.
Mm-mm.
This weekend, it's going to happen.
Oh, it has to. Both games.
I'll tell you one thing. Usually when I interview players, sometime during the game, they will get a point or score or do something. So let's keep that streak intact and alive, and you'll get something this weekend.
Of course. I already got my celebration planned out and pointing right at the camera, so you know back at home that this is what caused it. So.
Oh, okay, what's the celly?
Well, I'm going to be pointing right at the camera, right?
Oh,
at you.
Okay. So that's it. Your celly is right at the camera at center ice. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. We'll wait for it.
I love it.
All right. Thanks so much for doing this. This is Sam Stack of the Drury Panthers Senior. We'll take a break. Thanks, Sam. More hockey coming up in a moment.
Tri-Lakes Marines started with Pat and Eric working out of the back of their service truck, repairing boats and keeping folks on the water. Today, Tri-Lakes Marine is the largest Yamaha outboard dealer in the state. At Tri-Lakes Marine, you will find in-stock Yamaha outboards, G3 aluminum fishing boats, and a full lineup of Suncatcher pontoon boats. And Tri-Lakes Marine is still a full-service dealer with a complete Yamaha service center because maintenance matters. We take care of our customers. Check out our full lineup of boats and motors at Tri-Lakes Marine, 15 minutes south of Nixa on Highway 160.
This is what you're missing on Web Sports Radio in 30 seconds.
Well, Steve, you've probably had time to practice and learn and memorize the names of the new players, the numbers and all, and I'm just kind of coming here cold.
Dave, I am winging it. Joining me is Dan Lee. Dan, you're out of jail. Welcome.
I just happened to be coming by here to try to collect the $11.50 you owe me on our fantasy football league this year, and I still haven't got it.
I'm getting fingers, I'm getting points, I'm getting looks. Where's my director?
What are you trying to say? I haven't done this in a while? Is that what you're saying?
Basically.
Yeah, okay.
Well, you know, new rule change. Everything's changed. They play hockey on feet now.
Oh, I guess that really didn't work too well, did it? It's Missouri State Hockey on WebSportsRadio.com. Join us.
It's time to drop the puck on the second period. Here's Steve Kasson.
Along with Scott Lutzke keeping us on the air, and Amari Johnson doing great camera work for us. Both teams have made their way out onto the ice. There is a couple of additional penalties that were called. So Ethan O'Rourke gets 2 minutes for cross-checking. And Tyler Book gets 2 minutes. They didn't really throw the book at him, but he gets 2 minutes for roughing. And so those are now up on the board, and we will skate 4-on-4 to start this second period. I mentioned they updated the shots. A 12 put on Brett Sweet, 8 put on Grady Reese, and we are ready for period number 2. Panthers skate this time from the right to the left, and from the left to the right, it'll be the Arkansas Razorbacks across your viewing screen, and we are underway in period number 2. 2-0 for Arkansas. Both goals were scored by Kuhn, one on the power play. He got his 15th and 16th late in the first period. Panthers with Neil Serrato, back of his own zone. He's able to clear it and get it to Ferguson. Line pass comes now to the right side. A drive in by Hawley gets deflected away. And back deep into the Arkansas zone. 4-on-4 for a minute 26. Calling for it is Duenwald, and he picks it up at the red line. Intercepted, though, by Ferguson. He'll clear it for the Panthers. Now to Hawley. It's the line of Jacob Hawley, Keegan Ferguson, and we'll see who they have on that other line, because sitting in the box right now is Ethan O'Rourke. When we come the other way, 2-on-2, pass drive comes in by Duenwald, and a good save by the goaltender, Brett Sweet. Panthers. They have Schmitz out to block, and he's able to block. It comes to Brody Behan on the line. Behan will make his way through. We get a Panther down, and he cannot. Can Keegan Ferguson make it over to the bench? Do not know why. In that I did not see the play. Amari, were you able to catch that play?
I wasn't able to catch in the background, but I just saw the goalie, you know, slash one of the Drury players.
No penalties apparently, and O'Connor is motioning what he thought happened, which was a whack to the back of the leg, and the officials say no. Although they are coming over to the scorer's table. So I don't know why, unless there is a late penalty here. And nothing apparently is going to happen. 18:34 remaining in the period, 35 seconds in the coincidental minors, and there is going to be a penalty. Brendan Kuhn goes into the box. It's a penalty on the goaltender. Amari, you were correct.
To number 31, Grady Reese, 2 minutes for roughing. Time of the penalty, 1:36.
So it is a power play, but it's going to be a 4-on-3 power play. So the Panthers now working on power play number two. Puck drive from the left side, and as Hunter Findlay got it, it'll be covered by Reese. Mara, we should make you the official because you called that one, and that's what ended up getting called. The goaltender with the, they called it roughing, though.
Oh, that's true. You know what? I might try that for one day, you know? Just like, hey, ref, can I try it?
There you go. Do a TikTok as a ref.
I should, too, as a goalie.
What's your TikTok, by the way?
TikTok underscore K-T-R-E-L-L underscore, so underscore K-T-R-E-L underscore.
There we go. And Amari, of course, does the Web Sports Radio TikTok too, along with Emmeline. Here's a drive-in score from the left side, Hunter Findlay. Findlay gets the drive as he came from the top, slid over to the left, gets his fifth goal of the season. It is a power play goal as the Panthers are now trailing by a count of 2-1. So it should be a 5-on-5 scenario now, as that power play goal came as the coincidentals were expired.
Panthers goal, a power play goal! Scored by number 5, his fifth of the season, Hunter Findlay! Assisted on the goal by number 10, Ethan O'Rourke. And number 18, Riley O'Connor.
So the Panthers come roaring back, and every time we listen to the PA guy, it always happens. We should listen to him more often, but this one is going to be a goal up high over the shoulder of Reese by Neil Serrato, and he gets his fifth goal. And it's 2-2, and all of a sudden the Panthers have caught fire here in the second period.
Recapping the first goal from the Panthers at the 2:11 mark. Panthers goal scored by number 5, Hunter Finley, assisted by number 10, Ethan O'Rourke, and number 18, Riley O'Connor. At 2:25, Panthers goal! His fifth of the season, scored by number 2, Neil Serrato! Assisted on the play by number 19, Jake Holly, and number 81, Keegan Ferguson. Time of the goal, 2:25. Serrato from Holly and Ferguson at 2:25.
So the Panthers get goals 20 seconds apart, 2:05 and 2:25. And it's a 2-2 game. Stack is able to block the shot, and it's cleared all the way down. We get a cover up here. Shots 14-12 in favor of Drury. That means four shots in this period. The only four have been put on by the Panthers. And they have two goals on four shots. And we're 2-2. For Neil Serrato, that is his first goal since he had two goals against Iowa on December 9th. .1609 to go in the period. Puck sent down to the Drury zone. Cruz, centering pass. It connects, shot just missing wide. And the rebound is cleared into the corner. That came off the stick in front of Connor Chapman. Now the Panthers, Schmitz, he'll have it on the left side, looking for a centering pass. It comes right through off of a skate of the Panthers. It's their captain, Keegan Ferguson. Arkansas with it. They slowly get it out, and racing in front is Luke Kangas. He's able to send it down into the Arkansas end. 2-2 game. After Kuhn got two in the first, it's been Finley and Serrato both getting goal number 5. Now the Panthers come in a drive. Getting upended is Quinn O'Reilly. O'Reilly on top of the puck, and that could be pretty close to delay a game. Although O'Reilly is down and not getting up.
It looks like he tripped over the goaltender into the corner.
Yeah, and then he just kind of stayed down.
Starts are going to discuss it. Looks like it's no call.
So that benefits the Panthers on that. Clock rolling at 15:07. Shot in, blockered away by Reese into the near side boards, trying to grab it as Cannon Stegel. Stegel to work the puck. Puck is flipped out, held in though by Serrato. Was flipped up, I meant to say, not out of the zone though. Puck is taken away, and Francis Young-Menard will send it in on a delayed offside. 14:43 to go in the period. Puck chopped at and sent right back in by Young-Menard. Over to the corner. Keeping it in is Kangas. Luke with it this time. Luke with a centering pass. Nobody there. Grabbed by Brendan Kuhn. Already has two goals. Serrato. Did Luke Kangas. Drops it in. Kuhn is able to clear. Panthers almost had too many men. And Sam Stack smartly did not play the puck as he came out of the bench. He just waited for his other teammate to get back onto the bench before he played it. Smart play. Don't give the officials any reason to call anything. Buck sent in by Tyler Kane. It's the line of Stegel, Luke Kangas, and Tyler Kane. Puck back into the Panthers zone. Racing for it is Anson Kyle. Now here comes Kuhn with a shot in and a save. Rebound, we're going to get a penalty. Kane, I believe, is going to get called for tripping. Goaltender Sweet without his goaltending stick. Sweet kicks it away. Gifford with it. Centering right side. Drive in, and Sweet is able to deflect the shot by Yontz. Goaltender has the stick. Delayed call against the Panthers. They do touch it up now, and it will be a slashing call. And Kane will go to the box for slashing. Four penalties, 8 minutes against the Panthers. Three penalties, 6 minutes against the Razorbacks. Third power play goal for the Razorbacks. Both teams have scored a power play goal here today.
To number 80, Tyler Kane. 2 minute minor for slashing. Time of the penalty, 6:21.
Puck taken away with authority and cleared by Doggett all the way down. 1:43 to go in the power play for Arkansas on the penalty to Kane. Drop down into the Drury zone for an icing call. Icing will bring it back. It'll go into the Arkansas zone. This time yesterday, we were looking at still a 4-0 lead, maybe a 5-0 lead at this time yesterday for the Panthers. Big hit along the boards. Getting upended was Kangas. Puck goes right up the front. Nothing there, but Panthers take it away. And here might be a break. Finley has some room left side. Good defensive work in front by Kuhn to tip it away. 1 minute to go. Panthers shorthanded. They do have 6 shorthanded goals this season. 4 of them by a player who's been scratched tonight, and that's Matthew Teasdale. Whistle has been blown. It's a hand pass. No goal. No goal as a hand pass was called on the far side. So referee David Hill says no goal. And we're still tied up at 2. Young Menard. Now Serrato will help it get farther down. 37 seconds remaining in the penalty. Across the Panther line. Into the zone. Getting hit is Markovich. Looking at him was Serrato. Now Markovich and Serrato, they give words. Serrato still spinning around Markovich. Markovich talked to the official and said, are you going to call anything? He said, get up in the play. Young Menard, as he stares Duenwald, as they both discuss things in front of the Drury bench. Shots now 16-15 in favor of the Panthers. 3 seconds to go in the power play. Sent in by Gilligan. Power play is expired. Here come Arkansas. 2-2 contest. Driven down in. Worked behind the net. Gifford is there. But instead, it is Gilligan to take it for the Panthers. Cleared out to center. Here comes Keegan Ferguson. Ferguson looking for a return pass. Stays on the line. Sent back in by Gilligan. Send it to the corner. Gilligan with it.
Gilligan had one assist on October, and that's been it for him. We come the other way. 3-on-1 for Arkansas. Pass over, and Kylie is able to break it up. Now out in front, Sweet has to make a save, as right in front was Patterson. Panthers a little dangerous in their own zone, allowing Arkansas with a couple of great opportunities as we get an icing call here. 16-16 to the shots. Kyle Patterson got a goal last against Florida Gulf Coast on February 4th. Was looking for another one. 2-2. Yesterday's game was a 7-1 victory for Drury. This one is a much closer game. Drop down behind the net. Worked over by Daryl Smith. Now sent to the near side. Kyle Patterson is there to put some pressure on. Panthers are able to keep control. Here is a partially fanned on shot by Finley. And cleared out to center. Swept in on goal. Saved by Reese. Hunter Finley. Lead pass to Schwartz, or from Schwartz to Tyler Kane. Steered into the corner. Panthers do get a line change. 8:26 to go in a 2-2 contest. Panthers have it, and Schwartz misses wide. Dropped in. Good box out by Finley. Allows Kangas to get it. Now a shot in, missing wide on the spin by O'Reilly. 9:08 to go. Underneath the skate and stick of Schmitz, and it's out to center and back into the Panthers zone. Racing for it was Motor. Now Verbal with a pass up high. Carricker couldn't control it. Pass comes out to center. Arkansas will reset. Second period intermission guest will be Quinn O'Reilly. Taken by Schmitz. Over to the corner. Here's a drive in, and it hit Cruz. He was waiting to tip it in. It hit him and went wide. Finley gets pushed by Carricker. Kane comes in to push Carricker. Cruz is there. They battle for it along with Finley. And it's Arkansas to gain possession behind the net. Looking at out in front was Carricker, and a good deflection by Kane, and it's out to center. Back for the Drury Panthers in their own zone. Finley moves it ahead. Gets it across to Stegel into the zone. Panthers with a partial change. Grab by Chapman of Arkansas. Connor Chapman, third in scoring, 2 goals, 6 assists in his last 7 games. We get an icing call here. As Chapman not able to get to the puck. Face off back of the Arkansas end of the ice. Puck shoveled over to Francis Young-Menard. Gets it to Serrato with a drive, and it goes wide. Panthers a little dangerous on the blue line as they straddled that. Puck out to center. Knocked down. Here's Trevor Borlas. Borlas breaks free. Looks for a centering pass. Broken up, and it goes to Cruz. Now to the left side to Romero. Over to the right side to Hershey. Far side again. Centering pass. Broken up by Sweet as Borlas tried to look for it in front. Now Sweet will have to set things up for the Panthers. 7:04 to go in the period. It's been a quick one here as we are more than halfway through this game. Pucks in all the way down. Icing will be the call. 6:56 to go in the period. Kuhn got 15 and 16 in the first period. 16th was on the power play. Then in the second period, just 20 seconds apart, 2:05, Finley
gets his fifth, and then Serrato gets his fifth. And we are tied up at 2-2. Scott, I'm seeing different names now. I don't know what that means. Here is Sweet making a save, as coming in was Duenwald. Face off to the right of Sweet. One in, Sweet with the save. And the shot up high by Hershey. Comes out to Quinn O'Reilly, has a shot in, and a save by Reese. He'll hold on. .633 to go in this period. And it has been a fast-paced game here. Here comes Duenwald. Has a two-on-one. Duenwald, and a good sliding defensive move by Stack. Sam making the best of his senior night here. Here's a drive in, save, as that came off the stick of Duenwald. Or take that back, no, that's 11 Romero who got that shot. Dropped out in front with a drive, sliding down was Kuhn. Sweet with the save, the rebound cleared, but right into a Razorback. Grabbed by Markovich, had a goal in yesterday's game. Markovich with it. The only goal scorer for Arkansas. Dropped down now by Romero, the only assist getter in yesterday's game. Now we have Kangas is down. This one is Brady Kangas. But meanwhile, we have additional players going at it in the corner. .541 to go in the period. Shots 21-18, that does favor the Arkansas Razorbacks. We're gonna get a penalty. This is a roughing call. Kuhn will go in for roughing, and it will be power play number 3 for the Panthers. So,
penalty to number 14, Brendan Kuhn. 2 minute minor for roughing. Time of the penalty, 14-19.
The Panthers a chance to take the lead. Here's a drive in, just missing by Ferguson. It had been deflected in front. Over to the right side. Up to Francis Young-Menard with a drive and a good save by Reese. Rebound, back behind the net. Panthers have it along the boards now to O'Rourke. O'Rourke waits, he shoots, it's blocked. And Young-Menard will pick it up. Panthers have to retreat. Set things up again. They move it across the line. Racing in is O'Reilly, but it's cleared. Line change for Arkansas. Panthers have it. Quickly taken away from Stack and cleared out to center. Now here come the Panthers, good steal. Here is a drive in and a save and the rebound on the follow-up that goes wide. Keegan Ferguson with the initial drive, Quinn Riley. And O'Reilly gets the secondary shot as he gets one here and it's saved. Panthers putting all sorts of pressure on. 28 seconds remaining in the power play. Down low. Up high once again to Finley, left side. Now to Ferguson with a drive and it's blocked. Ferguson with it again. 13 to go in the power play. Ferguson left side. He shoots, missed wide. Racing over is Finley, but he can't get to it. It's taken away and cleared. Here's Finley across the line. We're back to 5-on-5. Yount steps in front of him. Arkansas with Kuhn, fresh out of the box, takes it away. Buck is backhanded by Ethan Motor and back into the arc, to the Drury zone. Good deflection by Kane. Now sent up over the net, and Sweet will make the save. That player coming out of the penalty box and picking up the puck reminds me of, I don't know if you saw the LA Kings-Boston game today.
I watched the third period of it and the overtime, of course.
LA looking like all sorts of nothing was going on, and they come back and Kopitar ties it. And then Brant Clark, who gets called for a penalty, when it's over with about 40 seconds left, he makes his way out of the penalty box and scores the overtime winner.
Yep, I did see that. I also saw the Rat get away with an elbow.
Yeah.
Never fails. He seems to get away. You know, everybody hates him unless he's on your team.
Absolutely.
Boston, I'm sure, loves having him.
Well, at least he doesn't lick ears anymore.
Mm-hmm. I thought he licked somebody this season again, didn't he?
I don't know.
I think he was told not to lick people anymore. I thought I saw something about him licking somebody else.
Talking about Brad Marchand of the Boston Bruins. So here's Kangas as we get back to this action here. His pass is broken up, taken away, and cleared by Trevor Borlas. 14 goals, 19 assists this season for him. Goes right out in front, and Sweet makes the save. The rebound comes right through. Panthers have it. Here's Kangas. This one is Luke. He'll shoot it in. Come all the way around. Panthers have it again. Drive from the right side. Sails high and wide. Came off the stick of Schmitz. 2:14 to go in the period. Panthers with some pressure. They get it right out in front. Work to the corner. It is cleared out to center, and Schmitz with it for Drury. Went up over the glove of Quinn O'Reilly and made its way with some help back into the Arkansas zone. Panthers steal again. Good neutral zone play by the Panthers. Keeping the pressure on Arkansas. Francis Young-Menard with 1:23 to go in a 2-2 game. Now Arkansas cannot clear. Poked away and helped out. Here comes Kuhn looking for three. Pass in front and trying to tip it over the net was Duenwald. And do we get a net dislodged or do we get a penalty? I think just the dislodged net. Oh no, we are going to get a penalty. And I think we're going to get more than just two. We're probably going to get two and 10 maybe. It's going to be called against Quinn O'Reilly. This will be the Razorbacks' fourth power play with 1:06 remaining. Draw one, shot just wide. Brendan Kuhn looking for his third, believe it or not. Roughing is the call. Here's Kuhn with it. Less than a minute to go in the period. Chapman, he'll spin it around right side. Now to the left side to Cruz. Has some room. He shoots. It's blocked. Young-Menard gets position, and he is able to clear it out to center ice. Almost a break. Gannon Stago looking for a break, but a great defensive work by Ethan Rogers. He would have been in the clear. 1:21 to go in the power play for Arkansas. Chance to take the lead. They come offside. .9 left in this period. .116 to go in the power play. Faceoff come outside the zone. Panthers do win it. And sent down where Sweet stops. Over to the corner, off of Hershey's stick, and back into the Razorback in with 6 seconds to go. That should do it for the period. As we get a pucks in and on goal, and that will finish out period number two.
With the score, Arkansas 2, Drury 2!
Shots on goal in the period. 15 on Brett Sweet, 2 period total of 27. 14 on Grady Reese, 2 period total of 22. Power plays, Drury 1 for 3, Arkansas 1 for 3, they're working on their fourth and they have 53 seconds left in that. Goals after Kuhn at 18:31 of the first, and then at 19:42 of the first gets his 15th and 16th. The last one on the power play, and it was 2-0. We go into the second period. At 2:05 on the power play, Finley his 5th, O'Rourke and O'Connor with the assist, 2-1. And then 20 seconds later, Serrato his 5th, Hawley and Ferguson, 2-2 is where we are after 2 periods of play. We'll take a break, and when we come back, Quinn O'Reilly will be our guest. We'll do that in just a moment, as it's a 2-2 game after 40 minutes of play.
This is Barrel Bob, MoDOT's Work Zone spokesbarrel. You'll be seeing more of me as the weather warms up. Crews will be working on our roads. That means lanes will be closed for construction and maintenance work on our highways. As you approach a work zone, please don't drive distracted. You need to pay attention. I want you and my friends working on the roads to all get home safely. Remember, buckle up and put down your phone. A message from the Missouri Department of Transportation.
We're back at Jordan Valley Ice Park, Stan Melton Ice Arena. Now with one of the newest members of the Drury Panthers and Quinn O'Reilly. And Quinn, welcome to the team. You've had a cup of coffee with the team too. So oh, yeah. What do you like so far about this hockey club?
I like how everyone just brought me in as a family. Like, they just treated me as one of their own, as like I've been here since the beginning of the semester. And the guys are a great group of guys, honestly. We always have fun. Everything we do, it's always together. Like, whenever we go out, it's everyone's invited. Like, we don't really leave anyone behind. So that's what I really liked about coming here.
No cliques, none of that stuff.
No.
Just all good.
It's all one family.
That's usually what most of the teams that live out of this rink are like. So that's a good thing for sure. As I mentioned, you made your way. The last place you played was with the Northern Colorado Eagles. Now, is that the same Eagles that was the WSHL team?
Yes. So okay. I played 3 years in the WSHL too. Also, I played for Wichita Junior Thunder. Then I got traded to the Eagles before the league folded back in COVID.
Yeah, that's exactly what happened. They were on hiatus,
yeah,
quote unquote, and it never came back, but. Yeah, and then I think they were the USPHL Premier League for a while there.
Yeah, now we were there for 3 years. Then all out of nowhere, they're the Grit now on the NAHL team in Colorado. There's a NAHL team in Colorado called the Grit, and it's the whole same organization. Just it got bought out by some NHL player named David Clarkson. So
you've had a history with that team now.
Oh, yeah.
So what is the difference? Obviously, you're going into college now. Now, the one thing that you do have to do is Well, you have to study. You have to go to school. So that's tough. But in juniors, it was different because all you really had to do was play hockey.
Go hockey, just work out, go hockey, and basically that's it. So it's it was a tough switch around from coming to juniors for 6 years and going into college.
Sure.
Because I graduated 2021 from high school, and I just wanted to focus on hockey. So the couple like the first weeks was tough, but I got the hang of it, which was fine. But it's just showing up to class every day. That's what sucks about it.
Yeah, that's the biggest thing is now all of a sudden you have a responsibility. And the difference is if they don't like you, you're not traded.
Yeah.
I mean,
you're just cut.
You're cut, but you know, the bottom line is you kind of have to work for it is what I meant. Yeah. You know, if you quote unquote don't fit within the team and the organization, there's somebody else that'll probably grab you and you're good to go. But here, you pretty much have to stay.
Yeah. Which is fine. I like that concept about it. And I was really helpful that Riley O'Connor helped me. Like the first day I moved in, I was hanging out with Riley, like OC. He just brought me into his wing. Then I've been hanging out. Fergie's a good guy also.
Mm-hmm.
But honestly, just the whole group of guys. Really, we're basically like a family out there, and it shows on the ice too when we're in like a tight game when we need like someone to score. Like we have people that can bear down in those opportunities and get one for us, and it showed against Maryville in that third period on that Saturday night game.
Yeah.
When we were down 4-2, and it just shows that like if we put our mind to something and like play our game, we can do whatever we want out there. We can skate with whoever we can.
Now, if they put Riley O'Connor and you on the same line, I'll tell you what, I'm going to get a little messed up. I'm probably going to call you Quinn O'Connor or some strange thing like that. And then Riley Quinn or who knows, I'm going to mess that up. But, you know, we'll see. I mean, they had a Kane and an Abel earlier this year. So, but what is your thought right now about this team? Well, before you say that, what made you decide to come to Drury first?
Honestly, I played against Jay Law when he coached the Springfield Express in the WS days.
Okay, yep.
And my dad and him stayed in touch. Like, I was supposed to come here at the beginning of the season, but I wanted to go to Colorado because I've been there for 4 years. It felt like home. But, then when I went to Colorado, our team got suspended for 3 years for allegations that didn't happen, I guess. But, J-Law just kept texting me through it all, and like he gave me like the support system I needed and I wanted for like a hockey coach, and I just feel like it's a new home away from home now.
And now, what do you feel about it? What do you feel about this team?
I feel like if we can go somewhere, if we do good regionals coming up, I feel like we have a chance to go to Natty's.
This is a team that only has one graduating senior, so the remainder of the team can stay together, probably pick up a couple of folks where you're missing in certain areas. But is this a team you feel that has gelled very well?
Oh, yeah. I feel like we have gelled very well, actually, and it helps on the ice also. Like, when someone goes down, we know someone's going to be there to back that guy up no matter what. Like, no buts, like, no questions asked. And I feel like it helps, I guess, yeah.
What's the difference? We talked about the fact that there's no school in the juniors, but what's the difference playing-wise, caliber-wise? What do you think it's better in college?
It's a lot more physical in college than it was in juniors when I played in the USP. And I like the physical game, so you will see me in it anywhere. And I tend to play a lot better when I play physical, so I do like bumping and hitting people, so that's what I like. That's what I can see out there more. Like every 5 seconds you're gonna get hit, even if you have the puck on your puck on your stick, you're always gonna get hit, and I love that about hockey. I wish there was more of that around.
Quinn O'Reilly is joining us of the Drury Panthers. Now, the one difference about juniors is, okay, there's fighting, I guess, per se, except for in the last 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Now, in college, there's really no fighting, but you can rough it up a little bit. You can scrum it up a little bit, and you don't have to worry about if you do it in the last 5 minutes either.
Yeah.
So is that a little bit of an advantage for you?
Yes, but you can't – I wouldn't fight with a cage on. That's really just
I think it's a stupid idea, because I wore a visor all my 4 years, like all my years of juniors, and I always called someone out for wearing a cage when they are old enough to wear a visor, and it's just, you shouldn't really fight when you have cages on.
Sure.
It's just really stupid, I think. But it doesn't really bother me if, like, I get hit in the head, I'll punch someone back. Like, I'll hold my own against out
sure.
there.
What do you like about this team? And it could be anything from where you're playing to the type of caliber that you play. And we've already talked about the way the team is and the way it makes you feel. But what else do you like about it in that respect?
I do like playing with OC and Louis Fournier. I think we call him Frenchie, so that's I feel like we've glued together. Like, we haven't had the opportunities. Like, we've had the opportunities, but we just can't really, like, bear down on them, which is fine. Like, the chances will come if we'll just, like, keep working at them. But I like playing. I'm on power play one with the red line, and I love O'Rourke, Ferguson, Holly, and Francis. They're good hockey players, and we can move the puck real well. We can always find that open spot. And I feel like we've been working hard in power play during practice, and I feel like we'll be scoring a lot of goals this weekend with the power play.
You're going to have a rare chance where you get to play in the juniors. Then you get to play in Division II. Next year, you get to play in Division I.
Oh, yeah.
So all of a sudden, there is this competition level that in the last 3 years is going to elevate. You ready for it?
Oh, yeah. I've been excited for college hockey since I can remember. That it was always my dream to play college hockey because my dad played pro hockey back in the CHL days, and he went to Acadia. He played U Sports in Canada, one of the best colleges in Canada. And he was the only hockey player to ever win two national championships. And he was a role model to me. So, like, I really wanted just to play college hockey and make him proud.
I would assume he got you into hockey?
Oh, yeah.
Do you remember when you first got on the ice?
When I was 3. I learned how to walk in skates, basically.
Interesting. So before you even really got to ride a bike or anything,
yeah,
you were on skates?
I was skating, yeah. Hockey's my life, basically. I've grown up watching hockey, playing hockey, basically lived at an ice rink growing up.
Did you get to play in the outdoor rinks a lot?
Oh, yeah. In Kansas City, we played at the KCIC. Then we played – I've played here before at Jordan Valley Ice Center, Ice Park. And I have – played in a lot of outdoor games, but I like the ODRs better, like the frozen lakes. I can never go wrong with a frozen lake.
Well, and the cool thing is, if you need to zam, you just move down
oh, yeah.
20 feet and you're good to go again.
Oh yeah.
Or some people create their own little zams, you know, they take
those
some
are
water.
Those are a nice invention. I want to make one of those one day.
That leads me to my next question. What do you want to be when you grow up?
Honestly, that's a hard question. Well, when I was a kid, it was a hockey player, obviously. But now that I'm grown up, something like, I just want to be involved in sports somehow, like a sports medicine or like a GM or a coach. Like, I just want to have a say in like a sports organization type thing.
So perhaps a business background that it can get you into that. Now, you know, it's not what you know, it's who you know.
Oh, yeah, it's who you know.
Speaking of who you know, who is your favorite hockey team?
Toronto Maple Leafs. My dad is from Canada, so I grew up watching Toronto all the time. Toronto Blue Jays, Toronto Maple Leafs, any Canadian team, really.
Now, the Leafs, if you are not on top of your game, you're not anything with the Leafs.
Oh, yeah. And I kind of feel bad because the media up there in Toronto, they're really hard on players that aren't doing what they're supposed to be doing, and I feel like that just would put more pressure on the players to do good. But I don't know. I have really nothing to say about that, honestly.
Do you think their top three will stay intact?
I think we should get rid of Tavares because he's getting old. He's a good captain, but I'd rather have Marner locked up for how many years
for
enough money, because him, William Nylander, and Matthews, they're going to be good hockey players for like 10 years. I think Matthews is going to break Gretzky's record.
Which one?
The goal record. I think so.
So you don't think that Ovechkin will break it?
I think Ovi will, but Matthews will beat Ovi.
And surpass him.
I think so.
Interesting. Okay. Okay. we'll see what happens. But speaking of goals, at the end of interviews, I wish players more goals. And let's see if you can get a few.
Thank you. I'll try.
Well, you're on a good line, as you mentioned. Oh, so yeah. one of the top lines. So let's see what happens this weekend. And as you do have three of the last four at home in the regular season, that's got to be good. How do you like playing in front of this crowd?
I honestly haven't played in front of this crowd, but I've been to one of their games. I came during the first semester to like just check it out. And yeah. The atmosphere, that was one of the reasons why I came here, because the atmosphere is so good. Like, everyone's involved. The media guys talking, like, it's just a nice place to play in, and you guys get a lot of fans, so I'm really excited. I'm looking forward to playing my first home game Saturday in front of these fans.
Quinn O'Reilly joining us of the Drury Panthers. Quinn, thanks so much for doing this.
Thank you so much for having me.
Appreciate it. We will take a break. Be back. More hockey coming up.
Hey, Missouri. Barrel Bob here. I'm MoDOT's Work Zone Spokesbarrel. I see a lot of distracted drivers in work zones not paying attention to the road. Distracted driving is the number one cause of crashes. The average text takes 5 seconds to read. At 55 miles per hour, you could travel the length of a football field blindfolded. Don't take the chance. I want you and my friends working on the roads to get home safely. Please buckle up and put your phone down. A message from the Missouri Department of Transportation.
Let's head for the third period. Here's Steve Kasson.
2-2 as we await the Drury Panthers. There you go. The Drury Panthers have made their way out onto the ice. Arkansas getting set up with Grady Reese in net. Getting his crease set and ready as Brett Sweet for the Drury Panthers. Keep in mind that there is 53 seconds left in Quinn O'Reilly's penalty. And when we talked to him, I didn't talk to him about penalties, but apparently he got one. So here we go with 53 seconds remaining in that. 2-2. Again, goals by Kuhn. He has two. And then for Drury, it's Finley and Serrato. They both got their fifth of the season. Panthers win the draw, and they'll send it down, stopped by Reese. Rogers behind the net. 44 seconds remaining in the power play for Arkansas. And both players, Cruz and Rogers, forgot the puck. They quickly get it up. And it'll be Borlas with a backhander in front, wasting some valuable time. Now left side, a drive that comes in by Chapman, missing wide. It's cleared up into the Razorback bench, so we'll have a faceoff. It'll come outside the zone at the faceoff dot next to the Razorback bench. 23 seconds left in the power play for Arkansas. Chapman coming in for Arkansas. And for Drury, it is Gannon Stegel, and Stegel does not win. Here's Kuhn, has some room, backhander in, and good deflection and good defensive work by the Panthers. It's taken away and cleared. That was Hunter Finley with that deflection work. Line change for Drury, and the Panthers do steal. O'Rourke has some room, one hands it in, and a good stick check by Reese as the power play has expired. Panthers had a chance to take the lead. Now Panthers steal the puck. It's dropped down in low. Hawley comes in. He puts a check on Rogers. It's taken away and cleared. Duenwald for Arkansas. Leads it in front with a drive, and a big save there as Markovic looking for his second consecutive goal in two games, that is. 18:30 to go in the period. 2-2 contest. Ferguson calling for the puck. And the Panthers not able to control its center. Hershey One goal, nine assists for Truman this season. Puck is at the half boards, and the Panthers will have it. Coming out is Francis Jung-Menard. Jung-Menard has some room, comes in front, he shoots, and it gets deflected by the stick of Grady Reese. Into the Panthers zone, line change for Arkansas. They keep the pressure on. Does Patterson now? Patterson behind the net, looking up top. It comes in, Ribeiro with a drive that missed wide. Panthers have it. They quickly get it out to center. It connects now with O'Reilly. He scores! Quinn O'Reilly gives the Panthers the lead on what looked like an innocent backhander, and it beats the goaltender, Reese. It's 3-2 Drury. At the last moment, he snaps it home. 3-2 on O'Reilly's second goal of the season.
Season scored by number 55, Quinn O'Reilly. Assisted on the play by number 3, Devin Gilligan, and number 2, Neil Serrato. Time of the goal, 2:25. O'Reilly from Gilligan and Serrato.
So the last two goals by the Panthers have been scored at 2:25.
Just to maintain the status quo, of course, you just talked to O'Reilly in an interview.
Yeah, like I said, I talked to these guys. Now, these interviews took place on Thursday, but I said to them, every time I talk to somebody, they end up scoring, and that's what happened. Here's Stegall. Although O'Reilly got a goal in yesterday's game, too. So, for now, Quinn O'Reilly has a two-game goal-scoring streak. Or let's see, no, he got an assist. Yeah, he got a goal and assist yesterday, so he has a two-game goal-scoring streak. Mentioned he's had a cup of coffee with the team. This is only his seventh game with the team. And his second goal. 3-2 Drury here in the third period. Puck is deflected out off of the stick of Corey Warden now. We get an icing call. .16:19 to go in the period. Again, if you joined us late, scratches Joseph Pachuta, Tyler Sillenpah, Jake Lyons, Brody Behan, Matthew Tisdale, Zahn Warner, Ben Parker, Patrick Labutis, Louis Fournier, Cody Larenko, all scratches for the Panthers. And they have possession of the puck now. Drive missing up high and wide. Sent by Schmitz. Schmitz had it for a moment. Chipped away by Jontz. Panthers keep it in. Now grabbed briefly by Gifford. Panthers keep it in once again. Now Patterson. Scratches for Arkansas. Vinick, Kahutashvili, Hall, Asher, and Kilgore all scratched. Back in the Arkansas zone for Jontz. Jontz lost the puck. Panthers steal across the line into the zone for Finley. Finley will send it around. Panthers late getting a man on, but he does come on. Here's a drive missing wide by Serrato. Past O'Rourke, now with Cruz for Arkansas. To Borlas. Panthers under 15 to go in this period. They have a 3-2 lead. Remember, this is Division 2 versus Division 3. Although next year, it'll be Division 1 squad. Now, there will be also for Drury, who is going Division One, as they will still continue to have a Division Three team. Arkansas going to Division Two. No word on if they're just going straight up or if they'll field another team or not. Panthers across the line to Ferguson, has some room, and Reese through some traffic makes the save.
Bruno's Italian Restaurant is a proud sponsor of Panthers Hockey. Visit www.sgfbrunos.com for more information.
Full sale change for everyone. Off the draw, Panthers have it. Reese makes the save. Rebound, O'Rourke just missed high and wide. Puck kept in, down in low. It goes to O'Connor. O'Connor with it. And it's funny, I joked with him about being on the line with Riley O'Connor and Quinn O'Reilly, and they put him there. Score from the left side! Sam Stack, the senior, gets his first goal with the Drury Panthers. An innocent play from the left side. He got it off, threw some traffic, and up over the shoulder of Reese. And the Panthers have taken a two-goal lead. We talked to Sam Stack earlier. He gets a goal. We talked to Quinn O'Reilly. He gets a goal. Four straight goals by Drury, two here in the third period, and Arkansas has taken a timeout. We'll take a quick timeout and be back.
Bye, honey. We love you.
How do you become the person you're really meant to be? How do you reach beyond what you thought was possible? The answer isn't about the destination. It's in the journey. It starts when you become part of something bigger. When you join a community that works together to lift each other up. A place where you form lifelong relationships and encounter life-changing experiences. It all starts when you go beyond. At Drury University, we take a personalized approach in combining hands-on learning, meaningful mentorship, and real-world results to make sure you have every opportunity to succeed in both your life and career.
Back at Jordan Valley Ice Park.
His first of the season! Scored by number 21, senior Sam Stack! Assisted on the play by number 18, Riley O'Connor. Time of the goal, 6:09. Stack, his first of the season from O'Connor at 6:09.
And while that was going on, Brett Sweet had to make a sweet save to keep it a 4-2 game. But Stack is a trivia question. He is the only senior to be a graduate now, well, after this season.
And score a goal on senior night.
That may happen quite a few more times, possibly, but he's definitely on the record books.
Completely missing from his celebration was the pointing at the camera, though.
I was going to say that, yes, because that did not happen.
I will be saying something to him about that, I think.
Absolutely. He pointed to his players, but that's okay. But either way, 13:05 to go. Here come the Panthers. They have a 4-2 lead, and they bring it back down into the Arkansas end. Huge, huge goal there by Stack. 12:50 to go in the period. And the Panthers have a two-goal lead. They're looking for more. Here's Kane. His pass goes through. Kangas is there. He's not able to grab it. Taken away. Good play by Stegel to get it away from the defense. Stegel with it, looking for some help. Bad pass through the middle, taken away by Motor, and he motors his way down. 12:23 to go in the period. 4-2 in favor of the Drury Panthers. They're looking to go to 16-6-2. That'll push Arkansas, if they do lose this game, to 18-11. That's a rare sight for Arkansas.
Well, this is a much different Arkansas team than we've seen in years past.
Absolutely. Too. They've graduated a lot of their seniors. 11:53 to go. Oh, bad pass comes right out in front. Carricker is there. He gets upended. Play can. No, we're going to get a penalty. It's a hooking call. Back referee Mark Marzola calls this one. And they're still trying to get the player to come over. It is Drury's Francis Young-Menard. He is going to go. Six penalties, 12 minutes. This will be the Razorbacks' fifth power play. .11:45 to go in the period.
Panthers penalty, number 13, Francis Dominard.
Scrum in the corner, held in, up high, makes its way from Hershey to the corner again by Romero. Past Hershey to the right side, on the line for Duenwall, he keeps it in. 1:40 to go in the power play. Racing through is Romero, and he was not able to get it as we still have a 4-2 contest. Buck cleared out, Hershey. He'll return with the puck. Bring it across the line. Hershey looking for a pass through. Up high, here is a blast in and a good blocker save after Hershey got the shot. Now up to Hershey again. He shoots in, blocker save once again. A return fire by Duenwald, and it rims all the way out. Panthers with a line change. Pass into the corner now. Gilligan is there. He cannot clear. Gilligan with a second effort, this time off the glass and down. 44 seconds remains in the power play. Coming up on 10:20 to go in period number three. It's been a fast game. And Drury, now with four straight goals, takes a 4-2 lead. Here's Cruz. Drop back to Ethan Rogers. He'll work it around. Rogers, three goals, 15 assists coming into today's game. Rogers eighth in scoring. Here's a drive, comes in, save, rebound, loose. It's up, and a backhander spin-around shot by Kuhn is blocked in front. Now another drive, this one by Borlas is steered aside. Sweet, doesn't have his goal stick. He's using a defenseman's stick. Shot comes in, missing wide. That means the defenseman is without a stick. That is Finley. Over to the corner now. Trying to get the goaltender stick back to him. They work it through, and the stick is dropped. Goaltender's stick is picked up. And Sweet has his own twig now. Here comes Arkansas. Here's a backhander by Borlas. Right out through, and it missed. Panthers on a line change. They work it in for Quinn O'Reilly on the backhand. He'll change too. Borlas to Patterson. He'll clear it out, stolen by Hawley. Regained by Patterson for Arkansas. Patterson working it down. 8 goals, 6 assists for Kyle this season. He's down low along the goal line. Now to the half boards. Panthers have it. Good deflection work by Hawley, but he wasn't able to control the puck. Now Hawley one-hands it out. Here we come to O'Rourke. 2-on-1. O'Rourke, he shoots, he missed up high as he had Ferguson on the left side. Hawley will get it out. Set it up again for the top line for the Drury Panthers. Puck dropped in. Book will pick it up. Freeman with it. Spins around for Arkansas. Gets it over to Darryl Smith. Back out to center. Intercepted by the Panthers. Chipped all the way down to Francis Young-Menard will be there to get in front of Tanner Freeman. 7:43 remains in a 4-2 game for Drury. Panthers in their own zone. Keegan Ferguson. Panthers, you can argue they're trying to kill time off. They have a 4-2 lead. They're controlling the game now all of a sudden. Don't want to be too complacent here. We get a whistle for an offside, a late whistle, but offside is called. Next goal important. As we take a live look at Missouri State and Maryville, no score in the first period. Yesterday's game was a 4-0 win for Maryville, and it looks like they came close to scoring there. But that's what's going on in Maryville between Missouri State Division I action and Maryville. Puck taken away and cleared. So, Scott, I don't know if you know about the WCHL podcast.
No.
So, Chris Perry, commissioner of the WCHL, puts on the WCHL podcast. And we joke that there's 12 or so listeners because most of them are Missouri State listeners. So,
actually, a couple seasons ago, he was here and interviewed you, did he not?
Other way around, I interviewed him.
You interviewed
him,
okay. So, yeah, I do know that.
And, there was a couple of other guys doing some other ACHA action, and they interviewed me, yes. But this is Chris Perry of the WCHL, the league that the Division I Ice Bears are in.
Right.
Anyway, he was kind of commenting about the fact that we did a live look-in the other day, and it was a live look-in of the Maryville versus Minot game.
Right.
As we get a save here. So I just joked with him and said, oh, you're upset because it's not a WCHL game and it's a Maryville Minot game? So
we're an equal opportunity company.
There you go. So if he is watching.
Of course he is. We know he is.
Yeah, well, he's got some WCHL duties to do as Sweet makes a save and it gets sent right through off of his glove. Now Sweet has to keep another attempt out in front by Kuhn, who's looking for the hat trick. Or is that 44? Nope, that is Kuhn, 14. He's out there also with 44 Markovich. But if Chris Perry is watching out there, thanks for being the great guy you are and at least giving us props. Puck sent in by the Panthers. Jontz is there to give it to Markovich. Markovich and Duenwald. They race it down. With now as we're coming up on the Cadence Insurance final five.
So Luke Kane just took a puck pretty hard in the neutral zone and skated off with a little bit of discomfort to the abdomen, it looks like.
We'll wait and see what happens. We know Ferguson came back after he was upended. Here comes Stegel. Has some room, shoots, and it goes behind the net after a deflection. Stegel again. Stegel working it down low. Up the middle, it gets deflected into the corner to Stack. Already has a goal here tonight. So Stack technically has a two-game point streak. He had an assist yesterday. And a goal here today. Puck off the boards. Cleared out to center to Cruz. Cruz will work it along the line. Now gets it in the zone left side. Cruz centering pass. Right out in front. It's deflected away. Cleared.
Once again, Arkansas puts up 40 shots on goal.
Yeah, 40 to 28.
I believe it was 40-25 yesterday.
I believe it was 40 to 28 yesterday, and that's what we are right now.
So we got a holding penalty here.
So it will be a call against Luke Kangas, who's arguing about this. Power play number 6 for the Razorbacks.
Clearly his pain has subsided.
After Kuhn got a couple of goals to make it 2-0 in the first, in the second, Finley and Serrato with their 5th of the season each. And then in the third, O'Reilly with his 2nd, Stack with his 1st. And that's where we are right now.
Luke Kangas, 2 minutes for holding. Time of the penalty, 16:20.
So holding is the call. And Kuhn will come back of his own zone. Behind his net, give it to Cruz. He lost it, puck stolen. Taken by the Panthers, Doggett. Doggett has it taken away from him, killing off some valuable time. Rogers to Cruz. Cruz left side pass, gets it across the line. Working it through was Chapman, and the Panthers are able to clear on the far side. Now Rogers. Worked all the way down. Serrato is there. Lets Rogers skate through for Arkansas. Comes over to Duenwald. Snaps it through on the right side. Nobody there. As changing was Rogers. 53 seconds remaining in the power play. 4-2 Panthers lead. Drury has 47 seconds left to kill in the penalty. To Luke Kangas, up high. We're going to work it to Hershey. Duenwald gets it over to Romero. Up high to Hershey. Romero right side. Left side, Duenwald. He shoots in. It's blocked. Rebound cleared. Just enough. Racing out. The goaltender is coming out. He missed it. In front. Score! Tyler Kane will get the goal. Kane's 5th of the season. As he races forward, the goaltender just misses on the attempt to clear. Does Grady Reese. Five-two on Kane's goal. You could argue it's an empty net goal, but it's not. We'll catch the
Panthers goal, his 5th of the season. A shorthanded goal scored by number 80, Tyler Kane. The unassisted goal comes at the 18-minute mark of the third period. Kane unassisted at 18 minutes.
It indeed is a shorthanded goal. I was going to say, you can argue it's an empty net goal. Because the goaltender came out, did Reese, and fanned on the shot, and now the Panthers with a 3-goal lead here, 1:23 remaining in the third. Puck is tipped away, good save on the return shot as Sweet is able to poke it into the corner on the attempt in front by Gifford. Panthers have it. Now work it across the line, into the zone.
There's 1 minute remaining in regulation. 1 minute remaining.
Here's the Gaunts. Now they work it through. Gifford over to the corner to Patterson, up the middle. Now as he tries to grab it. Cleared out to center. Fans on their feet. Stegel is there. 35 seconds to go. We get an icing call here. Drury trailing 2-0 in this game. have scored the last five goals to make it a 5-2 affair. Yesterday, they won 7-1 in what was a really easy game for them, if you want to call it that. 4-0 after one, 6-0 after two. Shots 42-30 in favor of Arkansas, but it has been Brett Sweet with a 900 save percentage who will go to 5-2 this season. 15 seconds remain. Puck is sent all the way down. They're going to wave off the icing as the goaltender had been pulled. Take that back. He had not been pulled. Reese came out, and that'll do it. I looked over in the corner, didn't see Reese, but he came out of the net to play the puck, and then I had a couple of people standing in front of me, so the final score, 5-2 Panthers. Shots on goal. Grady Reese faces 8 in the third, 3 period total of 30. And 15 in the third on Brett Sweet, 3 period total of 42. Power plays. Panthers were 1-for-3. Razorbacks were 1-for-6. But the 7th shorthanded goal in the season by the Panthers is Kane's, his 5th. That was the final goal of the game. So not only does Kane get his 2nd shorthanded goal of the year, it's the one that put things away at the 18-minute mark for the Panthers. Kuhn gets 2 in the first for Arkansas, and then in the second, Finley and Serrato. In the third, it's O'Reilly, Stack, and Kane. Stack gets his 1st with the Drury Panthers. Players congratulating each other. You see head coach Jeremy Law and assistant coach Cliff Cook. And then running through the line, Keller Sims. For Arkansas. I believe we're going to have a player of the game.
How about it, fans? Your Drury Panthers!
Maybe not.
Great weekend of hockey from your Panthers before they take off for their weekend.
So Drury improves to 16-6-2 on the season. Arkansas 18-11. As you see a couple of players talking with each other. Here we go.
Scoring his 1st goal of the season. Basically on his night. Your Joe's Gather and Play star of the game, number 21, Sam Stack.
Brother, what a night, man, huh? How about this?
Oh, my God, it's been amazing. I couldn't ask for a better game. It's honestly so fun.
You should have seen your mama's face when you scored that goal.
Oh, don't worry. I heard all of them. I heard them screaming the whole game. It was awesome.
So 2 victories in a row over Arkansas. You guys head up to Grand Rapids this coming weekend for regionals. Team is playing great hockey. What's the key to this weekend?
We're going to clean some things up in practice. I know the boys, we can play a lot better than that, but we're buzzing. We're going to go into the Natty strong. We're excited.
You really are buzzing. Regionals, your Joe's Gathering Place player of the game, number 21, Sam Stack.
So an interesting thing with regionals going on, and then after regionals, a couple of more games that Drury will play after
these games with Arkansas, and after the regionals, they will play games with Oklahoma State coming up in March, in the 1st and 2nd of March. That's going to do it for us here at Jordan Valley Ice Park and the Stan Melton Ice Arena, as the Drury Panthers get two victories, one in Arkansas, one here at Jordan Valley Ice Park. Two more games coming up, again, 1st and 2nd of March. That will be against Oklahoma State. We'll have those games for you. Scott, anything as far as live looking with Missouri State, see what they're doing?
Yeah, we can take a look real quick here. Let's see if... No, that's not live. That's still 0-0 in the first. For some reason, it's not live.
For some reason, we're watching an NHL game.
No, I think that's part of their commercials, so let's see if I can fix this real quick here.
I didn't know they had Oilers commercials. We're going to have to look into something like that. Maybe do some Kings commercials.
Yeah, that's it. Looks like the first period just ended.
Okay.
No, I can't get it right now. So, yeah, period's over, so.
That's all we know. Amari, it's a big win.
Oh, yeah.
What do you think about it?
It was a very great win. I was kind of like, Drury was kind of short earlier in the beginning of the game, and I was like, what's going on? Because this is our first game this semester, you know. We've seen Drury hockey and how they play of last semester in the fall, so I was excited for them to get that win, 5-2. But fortunately, the same Missouri State Ice Bears hockey, so we ain't getting no Andy tonight.
That's right. Absolutely.
That was live. They're in intermission.
That was their intermission?
That's their intermission commercials. So
oh,
it
okay.
is live. That was live, so it
Got
was
it.
Good to go, and I'm trying to fix something that's not
well,
broken.
Well, we need to get an NHL commercial. We got to find some sponsors.
Yeah, definitely for next season. If you're interested in getting your stuff on our products here, we can definitely work something out. I know you see Cadence Insurance on everything. We had to deal with them, and it worked out. And I said, well, I'll just give you everything because it's there. But all of these things are definitely available for you. You can sponsor the Final Five or the replays or the opening face-off or so many things. So. Yeah, just get a hold of us. All of our information's up in the top right left corner up there, and you can definitely get a hold of us.
Yeah,
so.
Or Steve at Web Sports Radio. Very simple if you want to email us.
Yep.
That'll work.
It was nice being here, too, and not having to wonder what the clock says.
Absolutely.
And the shots on goal. So.
And you don't have to wonder about the score either, because it's a 5-2 victory as the Drury Panthers take the sweep, one in Arkansas, as I mentioned before, and one right here at Jordan Valley Ice Park. That'll do it for us. Once again, the Panthers with a 5-2 victory as they get five straight goals after Arkansas scores a couple by Kuhn. Again, goals by Finley, Serrato, O'Reilly, Stack with his first as the senior, and Tyler Kane shorthanded. For Scott Lutzke, keeping us on the air right here at Jordan Valley Ice Park, and Amari Johnson, who's doing double duty. He's on TikTok right now. Go check him out. What's it again, Amari?
Hey, it's _KTRELL. Get that in there.
All right, get that in there. Thanks so much for tuning in. Again, we will have games for you after regionals coming up. It'll be Drury Panthers and Oklahoma State, the 1st and 2nd of March. Until then, good night, everyone.